Hello and welcome! Grafana Champion is here! My name is Daria Volkova and this channel helps utilize Grafana to its full potential. This video is about our variable plugin. After joining the business suite we are developing, we slightly changed its name. Please welcome the business variable panel for Grafana. Different name with the same valuable and unique functionality for business applications. Let's review what this plugin offers and how to use it. Are you ready? Let's go! What does the Business Variable plugin do? Some time ago, I published a very detailed video on this channel. I answered many questions such as what is the variable panel, how to set the basic configuration and then two connected variable panels, how to use the Grafana threshold for color coding, how to configure the tree view, how to add tabs to tree view, and how to use the key value variable format. I also reviewed many cosmetic features such as favorites, sorting, and visible search. The cherry on top was the redirection function, or how to create an illusion that users can see variable-specific analytics. In my example, I selected a device and showed device-specific charts accordingly. In this video, I wanted to review the new functionality we added since the last release, the Minimize Displayed mode. It looks like a drop-down with single or multi-selection. It extends in size if needed. If I unselect all values, then by default the remaining value turns to all. You can change that by setting the allow empty value to enabled. I will add back multiple selections. With a new parameter, if I unselect all values, the remaining value turns to null. You can allow users to enter values right into the panel. Set the allow custom value to enabled. Then on the dashboard, a user can click on the panel and start typing. After a user hit enter, the value gets saved in the browser and will be displayed in the listing for selection. The value does not go to the data source, and if a user clicks the X mark, the value disappears entirely. Sometimes a user must select quite a number of options from the list. In that event, the business variable panel might look like this, taking up too much screen space. You can set the maximum visible value to remediate this. I set it to 3. Only 3 values remain and the rest are hidden behind the plus 11. When you click on the drop-down, all selected values are highlighted and by another click, they are unselected. The table display mode. Now you can show the total and selected counts. For that, here in the header section, set the option to enabled. The first number is the count of selected options and the second number is the total. The next step is the new display mode slider. It is ideal when a user needs to select one single value from a long range. For instance, year selection looks very natural in the slider display mode. Text values are allowed as well. Here I display another slider to choose a month of the year. We improved the look and feel of the tree view tabs. First, if you have many tabs, they will automatically collapse into 3 vertical dots. Click on the dots to see the collapsed tabs. The selected tab always goes to the left to be displayed. The next feature is the synchronization of the business variable panels. It is better shown in the example. Here I have 2 dashboards with the replicated business variable panel on each. Each has 2 tabs, location and country. When I select one device, the first dashboard opens. When I select the second device, the second dashboard opens. But as you can see, the tabs are jumping. In the groups section, I can use the select group ID parameter to specify a unique word, which I can repeat on the other business variable panels. That will group and synchronize all business variable panels. When every panel from the group is open, the selected tab will be assigned to a group tab. The business variable panel is very popular. Users use it for various use cases. This popularity led to the advanced features, which are really needed if you are familiar with the panel and have been using it for quite a lot. Here is the advanced section. We added a new parameter. Select the dependent variable to reset. In this blog post, I described two possible scenarios in which the advanced parameter is needed. Please go there for more information. In addition to all I said, please note that the latest version of the Business Variable plugin requires Grafana 10 or Grafana 11. This might be a breaking change for some users, so be careful when deciding on the upgrade. We're excited about the upcoming months. The Business Suite will combine solutions for many business aspects of the fully functional web application: business calendar, business charts, business text panel, business variable panel, business image panel, business forms panel, business table panel, business news data source. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos and news. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.